What I remember about the rise of the Empire is how quiet it was. During the waning hours of the Clone Wars, the 501st Legion was discreetly transferred back to Coruscant. It was a silent trip. We all knew what was about to happen, what we're about to do. Did we have any doubts? Any private, traitorous thoughts? Perhaps, but no one said a word. Not on the flight to Coruscant, not when Order 66 came down, and not when we marched into the Jedi Temple. Not a word. Tonight, the fall of the Jedi is at hand. We have been directed by the highest authority to wipe out the insurgent Jedi Order that threatens our great empire. Our first objective is to capture the Council Chamber. Lord Vader will be our field commander. Let's keep the chatter low and move out.
Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Star Wars Battlefront 2, where today we are in the Jedi Temple on Coruscant, executing Order 66 on the Jedi who are currently residing within the Jedi Temple. This is a mission which, when I initially tried recording it, it took me, I think, about an hour, maybe half an hour to do. Because in a part of this mission, it's a really difficult section where you need to save a bookcase, but we'll get to that in a minute. Here you can see I'm kind of pushing quite aggressively, and because at this point of the recording session I was kind of just done with everything. It was like late at night. I had a fairly bad day at work and I was just like, I want to do this. Battlefront 2 always cheers me up, and like, it's just one of those games where I've spent so long playing it that I've gotten kind of good versus AI. And of course I've also gotten quite good at managing, you know, like health and ammo and everything. But part of this mission is very much avoiding the Jedi where you can, and if you have to engage them, taking them out relatively quickly using grenades is a fairly effective way of doing that. In some of the previous playthroughs I would lob a grenade into the council chamber just to like clear out any and all Jedi who try to spawn in and stop me from doing what I need to do.
Boom. Attention troops, double time to the library. The Jedi are attempting to destroy the library's holo books in direct defiance of command. Stop them.
So here I've switched to the engineer class just so that we can have the ability to repair the bookcases as they get damaged. And part of this decision was mostly around that repair ability that the engineer has.
Stop the destruction of the Jedi holobooks. If you can keep at least one of the bookcases intact for at least 2 minutes, command can scan the contents of the library.
So as you saw, I was making quick work of the Jedi. The shotgun is actually quite effective if you can catch the Jedi when they've got their guard down, because it takes a single blast and the Jedi have, you know, they fall pretty easily. Unfortunately, I die because I got a little bit too cocky. I thought I was going to take that Jedi out, but I didn't succeed. But jumping down, switching to the fusion cutter so that I can repair the bookcase somewhat, and then I switch back to the shotgun so that I can deal some damage to the Jedi and the Jedi guards, the temple guards. I actually don't know what those soldiers are called, but I switch to the shotgun so that I can deal damage to them and get them away from the bookcase. I spend a lot of this game kind of just quite tense, because it was a case of like, if I fail at any point after this, I gotta come back and I gotta do this all over again. And this is the part of the mission where I failed a lot, because it's 2 minutes where you gotta keep one bookcase alive. You don't need many bookcases, but you do need just the one. But I think after the initial couple of waves, it's quite easy, and it's just a simple matter of making sure that any Jedi who try to get in get stopped pretty close to the pretty far away from the bookcase. I've also found that focusing down on one bookcase and making sure that one bookcase stays alive is always a good idea. That way you can focus your attention on the one bookcase.
Efficient. Your next objectives are a pair of holocrons, rumored to contain the sum of Sith and Jedi knowledge. The first one is located on the comm room. Retrieve it and bring it to the veranda.
So moving on from the Jedi library, we are going to just quickly take out the remaining Jedi who are here, just as we make our way towards the, I think it's the Jedi control room, or it might be the Jedi holocron room. I don't know what name it's given, but as we push forward, I decide to switch to the Jet Trooper class, just because the Jet Trooper is quite good at moving across the map. And so getting in is the important bit. Getting into the holocron chamber is the important part of the mission. So, and I mean, obviously the MP launcher is quite effective at taking out Jedi. You know, you don't necessarily have to hit them, but I mean, sometimes hitting them is good. But if they're all clustered together, like with the grenade, it's quite easy to knock a chunk of them out. As you can see, I'm using the jetpack to get up and around the any Jedi who think that they're allowed to. Oh, almost got taken out there, but we survive. I quickly jump back up in the air with the jetpack, and I was like, hey, we'll go down the center of the map. That would be the quickest way to go. But there was a Jedi kind of just in the middle of the corridor, and I was like, yeah, no, not taking chances with that. So we move around, and I briefly consider coming outside to go around that way, but there was three or four Jedi there, as you could see, so I was like, no, we're gonna go back down the central hall, and we'll make our way to the veranda where the gunship is waiting to pick up the holocron that we have.
There he is, near the star chamber. You must defeat this Jedi and bring this holocron to the veranda drop-off point.
So here I've switched to Anakin Skywalker just because, well, I mean, the game offers you the chance, so I was like, hey, we'll just jump in as Anakin and we'll make short work of this Jedi Master who's holding the last holocron of, I think it's containing all of the names of any Force sensitives who haven't been taken in by the Jedi yet. So we move forward quite quickly, and Anakin's got the ability to force choke his opponents in the game, and so I use it to hold the Jedi still and move in close where I can then use my lightsaber to take them out. I did lose quite a bit of health doing that though. It was maybe a bit too aggressive. However, the heroes only have a limited time.
Excellent progress. With the last of the holocron secured, we can deal with the remainder of the Jedi here. Execute the three Jedi Masters who have poisoned the minds of their impressionable students against the Empire. Let them bear witness to the cost of rebellion.
So here I decide to be a bit more aggressive because we're almost finished with this mission. And if I'm smart about it, I figured, hey, we could knock out at least two of these Jedi with Anakin Skywalker. Unfortunately, I didn't manage the force meter, or my stamina meter, nearly as well as I should have. But we do manage to take out the two Jedi. Usually you would hope to use Anakin to take out all three of the Jedi Masters, and it would lead to a pretty quick end. But obviously, got killed by another Jedi, so I switched to the Jet Trooper class, and I spend quite a bit of time just trying to chase this one Jedi Master down, and I get him down to half health a couple of times, but he's a wriggly little bastard, and you know, you've got to chase him down, and because you're constantly trying to chase after him and he's ducking and weaving all over the place, it's really hard to lead shots, particularly with the EMP launcher. But I do try my hardest, and I do avoid him quite a few times. I was able to get past him and stuff. But I get a little bit annoyed with the fact that he keeps getting away from me, and I guess I got too close for something. But I was like, hey, I've almost got him. Another two shots and he's down. So unfortunately didn't get it, he got me. So I switched to the Clone Commander class, whose chain gun is really effective at pinning down groups of enemies, or if you need to, you can focus it down on one opponent, and it's really good at taking them out. As you can see, the Jedi fall pretty quickly. Died there, and we're running low on reinforcements now. So I notice this and I decide we're not going to be nearly as aggressive as we normally are, but we are going to try and duck and weave and call them out. And obviously we are successful in this mission. I unfortunately die after completing the mission, but the game still considers it a victory. As you can see, I kind of duck outside here where I figured, hey, I could bait him out or something, which is what I do. As you can see here, almost knocked him out with the first blast, but he got too close and I was like, I can't risk it. Knocked him out.
Primary mission objectives complete. The Jedi temple has been secured. With the fall of Coruscant and the elimination of the traitorous Jedi, Palpatine's rise to power was complete. In recognition of our service and loyalty to the Emperor, the 501st were placed under the direct command of Lord Vader. Armed with deadly new weapons, blazing new ships, and shiny new armor, our presence let the galaxy know that the days of the Old Republic were well and truly over. We were establishing a new era. An era of order and peace.